Who's your favourite character on The Simpsons?
I've always had a soft spot for Apu, partly because he's Indian. And when I was growing up, there weren't very many Indian people on TV. But also, he was a mathematician. Apu studied maths and physics at Caltech. And when I say Caltech, I mean the Calcutta Institute of Technology.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
I can't imagine a better time to have been an aspiring young scientist than in the early 70s. People were flying to the moon, technology was exciting, we were discovering new fundamental particles, the world was changing. So I loved physics. Through physics, you could understand how the universe worked. By the time I finished my degree in physics, I could see other people around me who were brighter than me, frankly. So I thought, well, I'll let those people carry on and do brilliant things. But what could I do that maybe some other people couldn't do? And so I thought maybe I'll become a science journalist. That seemed to be a good way of keeping close to the science, but trying to explain it to the rest of the world and get them as excited about science as I am. I worked at the BBC in the science department there. I've made films about volcanoes and I've made films about chess-playing computers. I met great scientists, I went to terrific laboratories, I interviewed Stephen Hawking. When I left television, I became a science writer. First, I wrote about Fermat's Last Theorem, and then I wrote a book about code breaking, and then wrote a book about cosmology. But it's really hard to find stories that nobody else has written about. It's really hard to find stories that I'm passionate about that I think other people may also be passionate about. So I was watching an episode of The Simpsons called The Wizard of Evergreen Terrace, where Homer wants to become an inventor, and he's in his basement building all sorts of gadgets. And there's a blackboard full of equations. One of the equations related to something called Fermat's Last Theorem, which was a great unsolved problem in mathematics. It's now been solved. Why is Fermat's Last Theorem appearing on The Simpsons? And then I went back and I started watching the shows over and over again. And I was just amazed at the sheer volume of mathematical content that's in The Simpsons. In the very first episode, there's a joke about calculus.
Derivative dy equals 3r squared dr over 3. Or R squared DR, or R D R R, hardy har har.
Oh yeah.
There's a reference to something called Euler's identity. There's an equation about the Riemann hypothesis, the traveling salesman problem. There are two movie theaters in Springfield. One of them is called the Googleplex. Kind of just sounds like a weird multiplex, but a Googleplex is an amazingly large number. So when I realized that there is so much mathematics in The Simpsons, it was an unmissable opportunity. Here was something that would surprise readers. Here's something that would reach out to fans of The Simpsons who maybe were a little bit curious about mathematics. I emailed one of the writers, David X. Cohen. He told me that he was a physicist as an undergraduate, that he did computer science as a master's degree, and he loved to sneak in little bits of maths. He said he wasn't the only one. There's a whole gang of these writers. Al Jean, who went to Harvard to study maths when he was only 16. Jeff Westbrook was a professor at Yale, gave it up to become a Simpsons writer, but they still love their math. And the way they communicate their love of math is by hiding it in the show when nobody's really looking.
I can recite pi to 40,000 places. The last digit is one.
Pi.
As I was writing about The Simpsons, my wife at the same time was writing a book about an Indian suffragette living in London. And so she would go to the British Library or the archives at Kew, and she would spend hours reading these diaries and transcribing the diaries. And she'd come home in the evening, having done all her research, walk through the door, see me doing my research, lying on the couch, watching The Simpsons. I kind of think I picked the right book to write there.